Hello, good afternoon. Tens of thousands of people have been marching through London in the first of a series of protests before next week's G20 summit. An alliance of more than 150 groups, including unions, charities, faith groups and environmental campaigners, are calling for action on poverty, jobs and climate change. John Brain reports.
One message delivered by thousands of people. This was a day when London echoed to the sounds of protest. Representatives of more than 100 different organisations marched through the capital. Their rallying cry, support for jobs, justice and the climate.
We've had depressions, we've had recessions, this is a boom and bust cycle that we're having and people are starting to get fed up with it.
We want really urgent action on on jobs, on help for people, the poorest people in the world, and definitely on climate.
We need change, I think people are angry. People want change and they want it now.
Governments need to heed the feelings of the people that they represent. And I hope that all the G20 leaders will recognise that they've got a major responsibility to work together.
The organisers of today's event have been anxious to ensure that it passes peacefully. But this is just the start of a week of protests in London, and the police know that sterner tests are to come.
With fears that widespread public disorder is being planned to coincide with the summit itself, the police are putting in place an unprecedented security operation. A total of 10,500 officer shifts will be worked next week. All police leave has been cancelled for Wednesday and Thursday. The total policing bill for the summit is expected to reach £7.2 million. No trouble today, but critics believe these demonstrators have identified the wrong target for their anger.
I think it's a very nice day out for all of the eccentrics, but if you want to help the world's poor, then bringing down the world's capitalist system, free trading system, is not the way to do it. The fact is that the free trade system has brought prosperity across the planet. It's raised 1 billion people out of poverty.
No! But today's protest has shown the depth of public anger over the financial crisis. The world's leaders will be hoping that anger doesn't boil over and distract from their attempts to solve it. John Brain, BBC News, Central London. Scotland's large